Pillman, dazed, perhaps going for either a DDT.
Suplex, he's going for a suplex off the top.
And Pillman countered.
What a beautiful counter move. Now Liger's hurt. Pillman needs to hit this and go for a cover.
Pillman crossbody. Leg is hooked. One, two, and a half. Did he get it?
No.
Man, that was 2 3/4. Just a millimeter away.
But remember something, Jim Ross. Close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades. That's all.
Pillman now must capitalize before Liger can regroup.
He needs to go for some more covers. Try to get the three count.
Powerbomb! Powerbomb! And again! Did he know another 2 1/2? Maybe more. Liger thought he had him with that powerbomb, and quite frankly, so did I. Pillman counters! Oh, what a move!
And again a two count.
That was a page out of Scott Steiner's playbook, Modified Frankenstein. Knee lift, and the Irish whip to the center of the ropes on the far side, and a DDT.
He's close to the rope, though. Yeah, Liger made it to the rope. He had enough sense about him and presence of mind. He was too close to the rope after that DDT. He got the arm out.
Liger at 212, Pillman at 223, and you have to wonder how much more their bodies can sustain of this high-impact punishment.
Whoa! We may get a double count out now. Both guys missing clotheslines. Both guys going for flying aerial moves, and it looked like they clunked heads right in the center of the ring.
Brian Bryan was a special team star for the Bengals. He's used to busting up those wedges on kickoffs, and that's exactly what it looked like there. Pillman again, a little groggy. He's right above us. And Liger takes the ropes, and Pillman comes down very uncomfortably. Again, Liger. Going for it all. Front face lock. Superplex. Oh!
Whoa.
Sending shockwaves up his spine. That'll be all done. No, no, it's not. This kid from Cincinnati will not quit.
Liger going to the top now. Again, high risk maneuver.
A Pillman move. Liger hit his head on the canvas. Flying Bryan using his legs. Bridging back. And he got it. He got it.